week one and week two, we learned the basics of autophagy and look at the Nobel Prize winning work of Dr. Osumi, which triggered the explosive development of the autophagy research field. This week, I will introduce several important works, each of which made seminal contributions to our understanding of the roles of autophagy in life and its relationship with human diseases. As I mentioned previously, autophagy is linked to play many roles in our bodies and to be involved in a number of diseases. The research I will introduce today showed that autophagy is involved in the starvation response, intracellular turnover, the response to microbial infection, and organelle homeostasis. These processes are also related to diseases including neurodegeneration. First, let's start with the role of autophagy in the starvation response. As discussed in week 2, Dr. Osumi's group discovered that yeast cells deficient in autophagy are sensitive to starvation and die more quickly than normal wild-type cells, demonstrating that autophagy is essential for cell survival under starvation conditions. These studies suggested that autophagic degradation of cellular components recycles degradation products as nutrients. A subsequent study by Osumi's group assessed the condition of cells defective for autophagy that were deprived of nutrients, including amino acids. This study showed that in the absence of autophagy, cells cannot maintain normal levels of amino acids. Amino acids, which are the products of protein degradation, are recycled to produce the proteins required by cells to cope with starvation. This study, therefore, drew an important link between autophagy and the recycling of cellular material, such as amino acids. The role of autophagy in the starvation response was also demonstrated in an intriguing study that looked at the birth of mice. Before birth, mouse fetuses are continuously fed by the mother through the umbilical cord, but after birth, they face the sudden onset of severe starvation until they are supplied with milk by the mother and digested. In this study, it was shown that newborn mice survived this initial period between birth and feeding by inducing autophagy. In addition to these cases, autophagy is also involved in other biological phenomena related to starvation. For instance, as I mentioned in week 2, yeast cells convert to a special type of cell called spore in response to starvation, and cells defective in autophagy cannot complete this process. Similarly, if autophagy doesn't occur, fruit fly larvae die during pupation, a stage at which it isn't able to eat anything. Again, a type of small worm known as a nematode transforms into a dour larva when it faces starvation, but this doesn't occur without autophagy. A social amoeba also respond to starvation by forming a floating body which produces spores, and autophagy is required for this process. As we can see in these examples, autophagy is essential for many phenomena that occur in association with nutrient starvation. Thus, the most important fundamental role of autophagy, which is conserved across virtually all eukaryotic species, is thought to be its role in the starvation response. Since starvation is one of the most commonly encountered problems facing the many forms of life in nature, it is thought that after the acquisition of autophagy by a primitive eukaryote, it has been conserved throughout evolution gaining additional functions along the way.